Standard precautions are the minimum infection prevention practices that apply to working with all people. The key is to eliminate the exposure to all blood, bodily fluids, and other potentially infectious materials. Standard precautions includes the use of hand washing and appropriate personal protective equipment, such as gloves, gowns, and masks, whenever exposure to body fluids is anticipated. Now, remember, wearing gloves does not eliminate the necessity for hand washing. In fact, hand washing is the single most effective way to prevent infection. Hands should be washed before and after a contact is made with a client. Wash hands during procedures as hands become soiled. Wash hands with soap and water, or use an alcohol-based hand rub immediately after removing your gloves. Follow your employer's exposure control plan. This is a written plan the employer must prepare to eliminate or minimize occupational exposures. Every workplace must have an easily accessible copy of its exposure control plan. The Bloodborne Pathogens Exposure Control Plan must include these things: a determination of an employee's exposure by job classification, the implementation of various methods of exposure control, including universal or standard precautions, engineering and work practice controls, personal protective equipment, information on the hepatitis B vaccination, communication of hazards to employees and training requirements, record keeping, procedures for evaluating circumstances surrounding exposure incidents, post-exposure evaluation and follow-up, and implementation methods for these elements. You see, the fundamental method of protecting against bloodborne pathogens and infection is by controlling hazards. This can be accomplished by elimination, which means getting rid of a hazard or hazardous task whenever possible. It can be also done by substitution, which means replacing a hazard or hazardous task with a safer equipment or method. And then engineering controls, which is using devices like sharps containers to block or eliminate the risk of getting stuck. And then personal protective equipment, otherwise known as PPE. Use it. Know where your personal protective equipment is and know how to use it properly. And then work practice and administrative controls, following policies and procedures that eliminate the risk. These different steps will make your workplace and your work activities much, much safer.